We're going to do something a little bit different today. Somebody asked me an Excel question, and I worked on it in Power Query, and some things came up, and I want to talk with you about those things rather than the how-to. The how-to might not be something that many people would need to know how to do, but something about the strategy was really important. When I saw that, I figured I need to drop everything and whoop this on my YouTube family, my Excel on Fire followers. Thank you for being part of my family. In this video, I'm going to show you two ways to do something, and then we're going to talk about the strategy. And I'm going to blaze through this. We've got a list of original codes. There's a location and then a date. And some of them are followed by a hyphen D. The desired result is to move that D to where it is right at the end of each location. So we've got the SWD. We've got a couple West Ds, a Central D. Let's do the first way. Cursor to the data set. And you know what's next. Data and then, yeah, from table slash range. Here we go. Table has headers. Column is highlighted. Split column by delimiter. I've got to split this by the hyphen capital D. Okay. Now we need the D back. Highlight this column. Replace values. Value defined, just leave that blank. Replace it with a capital D. Okay. Next, add column from examples. I'm going to go to the second one, SWD hyphen 011-62019. Let's go to this one, West capital D hyphen 05012017. Look at that. We've got NE. D, let's look at any that don't have a D, like row 8. That looks good. Great. Okay, accept that. Right click, remove other columns. Call this column by example method. File, close and load 2. Now, method 2, data. Table slash range. Split the column by delimiter by the hyphen D. Okay. Highlight, replace values. I want the capital D. Okay. Next, split this column by delimiter by the hyphen. Yes. Now I've got to deal with these dates. Because it got rid of the leading zeros. That first date should be 01 for January 16th of 2019. Let's deal with that. We got to add a column, custom column. Go here, equals, I'm going to put pad. All right, so we want text.pad start, open parentheses. The text we want to deal with is original codes 1.2. Double click, comma. How many characters do we always want? We want 4. 4 for the year, 2 for the day, 2 for the month. So we want 8, comma. And where there aren't 8, what do we want to put? Double quote, 0, double quote, close parentheses, okay. And we have an error because we have to deal with text. So we need a new step. I'm going to go up here to this change type. I'm going to change this to text. Yes. And I'm going to click replace current step. Go back to added custom. Now we have our leading zeros back. We don't need this column. Remove it. Now put this back together. Location. Hold on the control key. That D. Merge columns. I don't want a separator. Then the location, control key, select this column, merge columns, and I want a hyphen. So I'm going to select custom hyphen, call this wanted codes. Okay. Right click, remove other columns. It's a lot. Let's close and load this to the workbook. So we've got two ways to get this done. Let's compare them. I'm going to go back into here. Then I'm going to call this long way. So open up here and let's look at the column by example method. And then go back to the added custom column. That's where we used column by example. That's the formula column by example wrote to get this done. Table.addColumn, replace value, text.combine, text reverse, 9. There's so much going on here, I don't understand it. The person who needed this solution does this on a regular basis. If this was a one and done type of deal, I'd be fine taking this, these 18 rows and moving on. But if she's got several hundred rows and having to do this all the time, it would be really important to know what exactly is going on in this formula in case something does break or if it needs to be modified a little bit. And then there is the long way, where I did every single step. I know why I did it, and it took a long time, but I know exactly what's happening. This kind of thing comes up a lot when we ask for help, and the help we get back is beyond what we can understand. But then what happens in 6 months if it breaks or we need to modify something? We don't know what's going on. We don't know what to safely adjust. We're in trouble. That's what I wanted to talk with you about. We got these two different ways. One does seem inefficient and messy, and somebody might come along and say, "Man, you could have done that so much simpler." Then you reply, "Yeah, but this is the way that I know, understand, and can be responsible for." Please don't interpret what I'm saying as an excuse to not learn. But let's think about it this way. If we had this data and we had to go into a meeting tomorrow, and there's a possibility that somebody could question our data, or they want to know, "Wow, that was pretty cool. How did you do that?" The answer can't be, "Well, I got a solution that I just pasted in and I don't know how it works." Maybe in a week or 6 months, you'll understand that more concise, sophisticated way. But for now, for your needs now, sometimes it's best to go with what you know intimately, even though it might be ugly, but you can take responsibility for it.